The plant design, and welcome to the chemical process engineer journey. In this series, I share with you my experience as a chemical process engineer working with plant design. I answer questions and I talk a little bit of my daily life as a chemical process engineer. Today, I am in the Fortaleza Beach here because I'm doing some engineering startup activities for a plant, and I am in a hotel here just in this beach. And if you are aware of Fortaleza City, let me know in the comments or in the chat. And the main subject today is to talk about my understanding or my point of view about MTEC and also PAG. As you can see, it's a little bit noisy here because I am just near to the water here in the beach, and I decided to be quick to have some different places to talk about process engineering and design with you. So sorry for the noise, but if you want to know more about chemical process engineering and plant design, I strongly believe that my channel and my content is the best place to you be. So why I'm talking about the PAG and also MTEC subject, I received in my LinkedIn some time ago a question related to career development. The person asked me about he would like to improve their knowledge in chemical process engineering and design, and he already do that reading standard books, but he would like to know my opinion about doing PhD or MTech to improve even their knowledge. And in my point of view, it depends on the object that you have in life. To do a PhD, probably because the winds, there are too much noise here. And let's try for a while how it will see. Okay? And to do a PhD, it deserves a lot of dedication because you will need to study a lot, and you will need to develop your own point of view about a specific subject. You will need to propose a solution or something that is not already available in the science. So if you are talking about plant design, how is the relationship between PAG and plant design? If we are talking about doing chemical process engineering deliverables for plant design, the PAG will not help you straight to the point. It's not something that we will do and will guarantee to you a job in plant design. But not because of that, it's not important. Every time that you are increasing your knowledge, it will help you to improve your skills and improve your career in some way. But if you want to work with plant design, maybe it's not the fastest way to do that. Every time that you learn about something and you teach people about something, it's a great way to fix the things in your head. And if you want to improve more your knowledge, it's always interesting to be able to apply that to the real life. So if you learn about pumps and you teach people about pumps, but if you never select and size and select a pump, or if you never saw a pump running in the operations or in real life, I believe that your knowledge is not complete, because there are many conceptual in the books, but what happens in the real life to solve problems, sometimes you don't find in books. The experience is getting your knowledge to real life and help to solve the problem. So doing a PhD, I understand in my point of view, okay, maybe if you ask for Dawid Hanak about his point of view, will be totally different because he already has a PhD title. I don't have a PhD title, but I see the PhD title as important if you want to have academia career, because to have higher ranks in the academia, you need higher titles and you need to prove that. In real life, in plan design, you need to show the results. Results is much more important than only having titles. And of course, that you have titles with results, that is the best scenario for you or for everyone. One point of observation is when we are talking about jobs in plant design, in designing offices or plants or design department, you must take care to, depending on the location you are, to not be over, how can I say that in English, to not be over qualified. Sometimes you, for incredible that it can be, sometimes people will not hire you because you are overqualified. And if you don't need, and the PhD for sure is the toughest qualification that you can have in a career for sure. Even though you get the Nobel Prize, but that is not the point here. So if you are looking for working with plant design and you are interested of doing PhD, I don't see that as mandatory or even of great benefits for you at the first sight. Because for instance, here in Brazil, most people is getting the master degree that is equivalent to M.Tech, I think, in India. And that is a good qualification to be have a little bit higher qualification than the most of people has, but not to be overqualified. But if you are going to research and development career, probably the PhD will give you an advance for others candidates, because you need much more deeper or a deeper knowledge that you need to show to the department. You will be in research and development, you need much more researching tools to understand, and PhD will help you to that, because you deal with research, you deal with paper development, you deal with looking for solutions that doesn't exist already. In plant design, no. In few words, what I need to do is understand the problem, verify which are the chemical engineering principles or knowledge that I must have to deal that with that plant design, and I need to choose between the solutions that is already available in the market. For instance, if I want to work with producing hydrogen, I will not create a new hydrogen process from my mind, or I will not reinvent the wheel to produce hydrogen. I will search for the standards or the best efficiency process that already exists, and I will apply that for my process or for my project. The same for producing hydrogen, the same for producing polypropylene, and etc. So the mission of the chemical process engineer in plant design is to solve problems and using the solution that is already available in the market. But if I am working in a licensor that produces hydrogen plants, they have a specific department for research and development to verify new technologies to improve the efficiency and to improve to decrease the cost and to make a hydrogen technology more feasible to the market. So in this point of view, it's not, I'm not talking about plant design, I'm talking about research and development. A PhD will be eventually will fit better for this kind of position. And so based on that, you need to understand which are your objectives in your life. When you do a PhD, you go straight to deeper to a subject. You don't do a PhD, in my point of view, in chemical process engineering, You do a PhD in chemical process engineering, environmental, carbon capture with a specific technology, and you try to figure out which kind of new ideas you need to add to that. And if we are talking about master's degree is a level below PhD, but the procedure or the objective is quite the same. You will study a subject to get more knowledge based on that, and with that you get a title showing to the society that you are a master of science or equivalent in other countries. In any case, you must remember that master degree, especially here in Brazil, we need to dedicate a lot of time because it's more addressed for academia purpose. The university asks us to do a lot of papers because it's the papers that recognizes the teachers related to their master's knowledge. If a teacher has a lot of students that do papers for recognized or for famous magazines, they will get more credits in their career, and it is what matters for the teachers in the university. And in the industry, what matters is solving solution with the lowest cost, with the tightest, the shortest schedule, and if the machine stops, you need to know how to handle that. You need to understand how to deal with people, and that is what really matters in the real life. And remember, I'm not telling you that master or PhD is not important. That's not the point. They are important, but you need to understand how that addresses to your career. That is the point of view. And I love to work with chemical process engineering, plant design. Chemical process engineering, plant design eventually can lead you to many places in the world. As you can see, I am in the beach right now. I am not in the city that I live. I am in Fortaleza City. I am in a hotel here in the front of the beach, and in some minutes I will take my breakfast and go to the field that's far away from here to do the commissioning startup of the plant. But not doing a master degree or not doing a PhD, it doesn't mean that you will not improve your skills reading books and reading papers. That in last instance is that what you do in PhD and master degree courses. The difference is that you are not obligated, it's not mandatory to do papers, it's not mandatory to develop papers for presentation in forums or seminars. I don't have this kind of obligation, but I keep reading books, I keep reading papers, I keep talking to people that is more experienced in chemical engineering subjects than I, and that is what improves your knowledge in chemical process engineering and plant design. A point that is very important and people miss, especially in mathematical fields and logical fields, is that we need to deal with people. That's very important, that it's very important you include in your sets of skills the skills related to dealing with people. You need to know how to set your there is a intelligent coefficient and your quotient, and you need to improve your emotional quotient. That's the Daniel Goleman talks a little bit about that in his book, Emotional Intelligence. So instead of getting, especially if you are in the beginning of your career, you are just finishing your graduation, instead of expending all your energy improving your technical skills, I believe that you need to save some time to improve your social skills and also to improve your marketing skills. And let me talk a little bit about that. The social skills or personal development will help you to develop your inner self and handle the stress that you find in the industry. I just arrived here in the plant, and the project was done by a detail engineering company. And when I arrived at the field, I received from the supervisor that many of the documentation was not wrong, and many changes was needed to be done in the field. So the scenario is not a peaceful scenario. The scenario is stressful. The plant is stopped and must run in the 2 or 3 days ahead. And if as things is not going good, the stress increases and the attrition with people can increase, and you need to know how to handle that to have a better environment, a job environment, because the stress pass and you don't want to create enemies in any place, not in your personal life and not in your job. And knowing how to deal with people, it's very important in my point of view, and that's why I dedicate part of my time to read and to learn more about that kind of stuff. On the other hand, you can be the topest or the best engineer in the world, but if people is not aware that you are the best engineer, you will not improve the chances that you have to get a promotion, or you will not improve the chances that you have to get a new job, because people buy what they know, people buy what they understand that can bring result to them. And when we are talking about the job market, that's the same apply to us. Just to let you know, I started sharing my experience in the internet in 2010, and since then I keep with my regular job in an energy company, but time to time people asked me to do some kind of consultancy, they asked me to do some kind of extra work after my job to help them to solve problems. But that is only possible because I share my knowledge in the internet. And if you are interested in sharing your expertise or your knowledge in the internet, what I recommend you to do is to use LinkedIn wisely and use LinkedIn constantly. You need to be always posting, but in a strategic way. I see people sharing posts in LinkedIn for getting job or to improve the marketing in the internet, but it's not a matter of posting tons of content in the internet in one day and don't do that in the other day. There are strategies for that, and just in few words to not take too much about the subject is post twice a week and wait at least 48 hours between one post and another, because this way you will get more response for your post. So talking about MTech EPAG, this is what I would like to share with you. I have some minutes here left, and let me see if I have any comments in the chat. today I don't have any comments in the chat. So guys, here again, I am in Fortaleza Beach. See the view here. It was very nice to do this kind of live session in the beach. It was very different. And sorry for the noise, it's the wind, very noisy here because of the wind and the water. But if you like it, subscribe to the channel. And if you want to know more about commissioning startup, I had a video that I will let the link available to you just in the description of this one. So this is it. I hope you like it, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye.